everyone, and welcome to Hunter's Lodge. It's been a year since the channel was born, and I wanted to prepare a video to celebrate this year together and also finally create a permanent intro for the channel. So, first of all, let me thank all the subscribers for their support in this amazing year, where I've grown both as a creator and as a person thanks to the feedback and all the challenges we faced. Let's start this celebration by describing the channel a bit and how it has changed during this year. Hunter's Lodge was a project that I started hoping to bring the love I have for gaming into YouTube, but most of all the love I have for stories and the way they are represented by this type of media. My initial plan was to provide the content for every platform, but I found it to be a little bit difficult with the time I have, and I also wanted to provide you with a daily dose of content to appreciate at full the work I put into every video. So the focus switched a little bit onto mobile, where I found it was easy to record games on the go, and where I had quite a roster of amazing games, mostly gacha, that I love to play, be it at home, outside, at the gym, and so on. So I focused on my main titles right now, which are Dragaia Lost, Fate Grand Order, Fire Emblem Heroes, Pokémon Masters, and at the time also Dragon Ball Legends. Over time, however, we also added a ton of other games, such as Sword Art Online, Alicization Rising Steel, Tales of Crestoria, Danmemo, Sino Allies, the full playthrough of Dragon Ball Z Kakarot without any sort of commentary, which could be a mistake or not, we will see in the future, and so on, a ton of other games which aren't the main focus of the channel, but that I enjoy to bring every now and then when there's something interesting to tell or to show. I also wanted to officially announce that I will cover Genshin Impact on the channel. I still have to decide if I want to do a playthrough or do the usual treatment that I have for gacha games, where I only cover gacha stories and some guides, we will see together. And this is it for the presentation of the games for the channel, but what content do I provide? I mainly focus on stories, as many of you know, editing them together, adding some narrative role in some, like the recent cast stories, and provide them to you in their purest way, without any sort of distortion with voices and so on. It isn't probably the best approach to show myself to you, but I love if you immerse yourself in those stories, like I did, and still do. I also provide a ton of guides, showcases, and similar kind of videos where I show you with my amazing voice, and it's a really unique accent, of course, which makes me have some sort of mistakes sometimes when I speak, and I use it to help you through challenges or to present you with a cool new or old character in some games. Through the year, more and more of my presence has been added to the videos, which hopefully you guys appreciate, since it was sort of a difficult change to do to my approach to games. And I also started to renovate graphics and add YouTube chapters to every video on the channel, which is still a work in progress, of course, since this is quite difficult to do in just one go. Hopefully you guys appreciate the effort that I add into every video going forward. I still have room to improve, and hopefully with your feedback I can find ways to do so. Anyway, I appreciate, as I said, if you lend me your feedback, or even your support to make the channel the dream that I envisioned when I started it. A place where everyone can enjoy the story of their favorite game, or maybe find something new to try among the sea of tales that is the current video game world. So now, let's start with some updates on the games I'm playing and what I plan to add for the next year. Dragaia Lost. Many of you love Dragaia Lost, and count me on that list. It's finally time to give you some updates on where I want to lead the channel past the Adventure Story playlist, which saw an incredible participation both by you, the viewers, and also people like Starshade and others in the future, hopefully, who helped me fill it up with a ton of adventure stories that I didn't have. I can safely say that we are nearing its completion, with more than 150 stories, and when it's done, I want for you all to enjoy it at its full. That's why I decided to add YouTube chapters to all the stories, which I already started doing, to also renovate every thumbnail with the new style, and also fix some of the story where the quality wasn't up to standard, for example the recently released Galabrinth story. I also decided to sort the story on the playlist by the order they listed in game, so Prince, Elisan, Ranzal, and so on. But let's talk about the news. I started a Castle Stories series, with the name not being too original, I might add, This series will cover two or three cast stories every episode, and it won't be as frequent as the adventure story, but it will be a sort of different experience, since I decided to be a little more involved, because they are less united than the adventure stories, which are a single tale in multiple chapters that I put together. And to add to this, I also started a new Akido Versus Adventure series and also a future Dragon Stories series that will be a sort of mix between the adventure stories and the cast of stories, where I add my input, but I also have some parts that aren't with my voice. So if you hate my voice for whatever reason, hopefully not, you will find some sort of adventure stories nostalgia there. While the first one will be a sort of a character showcase in the Fire Emblem Heroes style, where I show you a fight versus the Akido or harder bosses in the future maybe, in expert difficulty. I also will add my own take on the character, if I enjoy them, if I recommend doing the mana spiral and so on, and also which builds I find fun or good to use. Always remember that I don't play optimally on Dragalia Lost, since I find more fun in building my own character and having fun with that, so don't expect to always have the best build ever or the best character ever. I love Dragalia, and the fact that my channel has started alongside its anniversary, it's both an honor and a testament to how much I love the game. So I hope that we'll get another amazing year together, and I hope that you look forward to what the future brings. This was recorded before the Dragalia Digest, so I still don't know what will come next, but hopefully it will be something that will add another layer of videos to the channel, which I'd love to have, of course. It's not something that I hate. So, thank you very much once again to all the Dragalia Lost fans, to all who supported the adventure stories, and to all who still stick around in the channel just for this game. You are appreciated. I love the game, I won't drop it until it's dead, hopefully never. So, thank you very much for the support to all the Dragalia Lost fans, and let's move on to the next game. Fire Emblem Heroes. The support for Forging Bonds has been amazing, a ton of you interact in the comments and love the different stories we get from this game. I share that sentiment as well, and hope that eventually we get a rerun for every story that I missed, unfortunately because of my own negligence at the time. I also started an updated showcase series, where I show you a character, their builds, quotes and so on in a single video. I really like doing them, even though they are kinda draining my resources, so it is hard to keep up, but fortunately we get a break every now and then with the new Forging Bonds, new chapter of the main stories, and also new content that I like to bring, such as informative videos and so on. I also have some alternate series, such as the Hall of Forms, one that I post because I didn't see much engagement from you guys, so maybe in the future I will give them a try again when they will be more popular. The news that I have for Fire Emblem Heroes is that I am planning to add a new series, where I will cover, instead of a single character, an entire team that is based around a team in general, such as, for example, a Forging Bonds story, a similarity or a bond that is shared in the main game, for example, the classes in Three Houses, the Grail Mercenaries, and so on. You can find a ton of teams that you can build around a team, so hopefully you will enjoy this series that will come in the future, so not right now. Not much else to say, since some series launched recently, but thank you so much for the support, and I hope that my videos both help you build a character or give you an interesting tale to read for some of your favorite characters from different Fire Emblem series. I also plan in the future to maybe do a playthrough of the Switch title Fire Emblem Three Houses, so hopefully look forward to that, it will be when I manage to get around to getting a capture card. So thank you so much once again to the Fire Emblem Heroes fans, hopefully you enjoy the content, and let's move on to the next game. Fate Grand Order. Here comes the story library of the channel, probably one of my favorite franchises. I brought you so many event stories, character interludes and entire chapters of the main story for this game, entirely in English, complete with fights and sometimes also my own commentary. But I want to add myself even more into the videos beyond the gacha pools and the reviews. So I decided to do videos about the difficult challenges that you face during events, much like the current Jin Fest, or do even more reviews of stories, characters, and so on. The last two additions are kinda of a project, so I'm not sure how they will turn out, but hopefully they will be good, since I love this game like many of you do, and I hope that you will enjoy whatever video series I will start. Other than that, we still have a ton of Lost Bells and other events to cover, so hopefully you still enjoy the style where I don't really intrude into the video myself to ruin the experience, plus the not so frequent gachas where we have not EX rank luck, but S maybe or A+. So I hope that you join me in this adventure that I can't stop loving, and that you will join me once again in trying to find out if I can get my target for each year. So thank you very much for all the faithful Grand Order viewers. I know that the game isn't as frequent as the other main games in the channel, but you know how the schedule is for this game, the rerun health and so on. So now we move on to the last game of the main series, which is Pokémon Masters EX. Everybody loves Pokémon, and with the recent anniversary, a ton of potential interesting scenarios opened up. I will start very soon to begin new showcases, completely with my own voice acting behind it, and single-grade showcases, plus a new type of showcases, more uncommon of course, which are the EX showcases, covering a character which I managed to upgrade to 6 stars EX. They will begin with Rosa, which was given for free, and probably Leaf or Red coming very soon. The showcases, of course, much like the Fire Emblem Heroes one and the Dragalia Lost ones, have both build showcase, quotes, animations and so on, and also the gameplay. So you can find your favorite character from the Pokémon series, see if you like them, if you like the animation, their quotes and so on, and then use them in the game to full force and other type of content that requires a really strong trainer. I of course also plan to continue the guides for both Champion Stadium, Full Force Battles and Legendary Arena. I've seen that many of you find them useful, so I can't really say that I don't enjoy feeling like I helped someone. Let me know to upgrade them with feedback and so on, since I really enjoy making guides, but for now I will continue with this endeavor. For the future, there's room for new videos covering stories and so on, similarly to reviews, depending on how the game will evolve in its second year. I like the idea for egg events and other stuff, so we will see if there is something interesting to cover for the future. Once again, thank you very much for all the Pokémon Master EX players. I know it's a new game, but I found a ton of support in some videos and in others less, but I still enjoy doing them anyway. I don't really mind the less viewership, but I love the game, so I will continue doing content for the game, don't worry, I will still be around for Pokémon Masters EX. That said, we are done covering the 4 main games of the channel, so let's move into a more general news approach for the channel and see what I will bring for the future. Ok, so more onto general news, but not less important of course, we have the other games of the channel. To recap quickly, Sword Art Online, Alice in Session, Rising Steel, I will keep doing event stories and gacha pulls on the weekends as usual, nothing there to change, maybe if we get new features I will consider adding them in place of the weekly gacha event when I don't have enough gems, but we will see in the future. For Sinnoh Allies, it will be a sort of game that I will bring some weeks I want, depending on if the event interests me and so on. For Seven Deadly Sins Grand Cross, I kinda got fed up with the game after some monetization changes, so right now I'm not really planning to bring it. However, with a future King of Fighters collab, maybe I will come back for that. For Danmemo, I still like the Danmemo stories and gacha, so sometimes if I feel like the gacha is interesting, I will bring it to the channel. Hopefully you guys enjoy the interaction that we have with that series, since it is a game that I find very relaxing to play compared to the other gachas that I have. For Dragon Ball Legends, it is a game that I never disinstalled, since I play it a ton at the gym when I do my Tapiru Lan sessions while I'm running, since I find it really, it pumps your blood, you know, when you run and you play Dragon Ball Legends, so who knows, in the future it may make a comeback, it may not, we will see. Other news, so we have a new interesting gacha incoming, probably the day after this video, which is Genshin Impact. Genshin Impact is a game that will release both on Android and PC, so I may be planning to play it on PC, but since it shares the data with the Android version, I will play on both. You guys can decide whenever you prefer to watch on Android or on PC. I kind of prefer the PC, maybe because the recording quality is a little bit higher, we will see. But it is a game that I really really look forward to, since it is very loosely inspired on Breath of the Wild. It is very inspired on Breath of the Wild. And I really like the character models, the idea behind it, and the general feeling that I got from the trailers. Hopefully it will be good. If it is, it might even become a main game of the channel, we will see. I will try to bring you both a playthrough, a gacha session with similarly to other games in the channel, and also adventure stories, but in another format, more similar to caster stories rather than the usual unvoiced video that I do for adventure stories. Other than that, I also am planning to do main gameplay videos, such as a playthrough of different games that are at mobile, if I manage to buy a capture card. If I do, I'm not really sure if I want to do a side channel with this sort of games, or if I still want to upload them on the main channel. It will be games connected to our main games, such as Fate Extella, for example, Fire Emblem Heroes 3 Houses, Pokémon Sword and Pokémon Shield DLC. We will see, there is a ton of potential to be found there. Let me know in the comments of this video or in private if you like the idea, if you want it to see on a side channel because you want this channel to be focused entirely on mobile. I am open to the idea. This is a really future project, however, so don't count on it coming right away. Anyway, I don't think there is anything else to cover. Hopefully I gave you a rough idea on what the channel is about. If I didn't, remember that I'm always in the comments or on private if you want more info. I really really enjoy the support, guys, it has been an amazing year together. We still have a ton of room to improve, to get beyond the 1000 subscribers, so that I can get some money to invest on the channel, get you more gachas, get you more quality content for the channel, and also to help myself live, since of course I do need to live. But guys, thank you very much for 1 year with Hunter Lodge. You can call me Lorik if you want, if you don't want to use Hunter Lodge for every... since it is more of a title for the channel rather than for myself. You might have gotten by now that I use the name Lorik for all my games, so that's my name if you want to use it. I am really really happy for this project, I'm really really happy to have made this video, which probably was one of my toughest videos yet, since it used a different sort of projection to it, since I had to do other different stuff to put it together. Hope you guys enjoy it. This will be the trailer for the next year. I will do another trailer in 1 year for the next year of Hunter's Lodge, if we get there hopefully. Once again guys, thank you all, subscribers, viewers, haters, non-haters, whoever you are, thank you so much for tuning in for Hunter's Lodge, for seeing stories together, for learning from my guides, or for making me learn from your comments, for providing an experience of community together that I really really seek for this channel. So, as usual, this is Hunter Lodge, and I'm out.